In this video, I'm going to demonstrate how to send a document to be signed electronically with no software to download. As an example, I'm going to send a quote to a client to be signed, and I will be starting from scratch on all of the accounts just to show how easy it is to get started in .q. To begin, just open up a web browser and navigate to .q.com. Click Create New Account and choose a plan. Free will be fine for now. Enter in your contact information and specify a username, password. No credit card information will be required. Click Continue. Check the email from the account that you entered, and there will be an activation email from .q. Click on the link in the email, and you're now ready to get started with .q. From the main screen, you can upload a document from your computer or from a URL. If you have the .q on-ramp installed, anything that you can print to paper, you can create a PDF of it and automatically send it to .q. So as an example, I have a quote here in Word. With the on-ramp, I'll print to the .q printer, enter in my account information, and specify the document title, and the document will be automatically opened in the .q viewer. With .q, there's 5 different form fields that you can use. For this example, I'm just going to use a couple of simple text fields and enter in the signature field from the markup menu. Click Send and enter in the email address of your recipient. You can enter in a subject and message as well. And you can specify the permissions here on the right. The document is now sent. If I log in this email address, I'll see the message from .q in the inbox. If I click on the link, opens up the document. You can now go ahead and fill out the form. And just double click to sign. I'll need to establish the identity here by just specifying a username, first and last name, and agreeing to the terms of service. I can now use my mouse to electronically sign the document. Click Apply, and you can see in .q the signature is now verified. Click Save and Reply, read through the signature agreement, and I can add a short message here to send back. The user can now quickly go ahead and activate the account. Again, click on the link in the email, set the password, and they'll be ready to get started. If I now log back into the original email address, I'll see a message from .q. I can see the document has already been signed. If I click on the link, it'll take me right to the document. If I need to print or download a document, I can do that now. And again, you can see that the signature has been verified in .q. One of the unique aspects of the .q verified digital signature is that any changes that happen to this document now will automatically invalidate the signature. If I try and add even a simple text field here and save it, .q gives me a message saying that it will be invalidated. If I hover over it now, I can see that it's been invalidated. The reason being, the version of this document is not the version that the client signed, and .q recognizes that. Thanks for watching. Let us know if you have any questions or comments, and feel free and try it out for yourself at .q.com.